Welcome back, everybody. We're hopping into the pistol round.
Indeed.
Oh, not quite the pistol round. It looks like we're not quite ready yet. But the knife did already happen. Three's up, won that. So I assume
they'll
be...
They did not.
Did they not? I thought...
Luminosity won in Twitch, so they will be starting on the CT.
Oh, my bad. I thought I saw Professor Chaos typing stay. Was he just trolling?
Yeah, he was definitely...
Damn you, Professor Chaos.
Hoping for the best. As this will be maybe a little bit better chance for Three's Up. We did actually see them beat Luminosity on train on LAN back in September, but it was a bit different of a roster for Three's Up at that time, so can't really use that for too much reference. But we can also add that it's not as if Luminosity plays train a whole heck of a lot. They played it once at RGN against Enemy, but other than that, they only play it online like when it's forced on. Like, it's not like a go-to map for them or anything like that. It's one of their least played maps actually this year, so... Maybe that helps Threes Up a little bit. We'll see.
Well, even if that's the case, it seems like they've been doing pretty well, winning against Conquest, Winter Fox, Follow Esports, and Enemy all within the last month or two.
I'm just trying to give Threes Up some hope, man.
Yeah, that's true. I shouldn't even have reported that information.
They did recently beat Cloud9 as well, Threes Up did, in the ESEA Pro League. So there's a little bit of something there going on for Threes Up, but we'll see if they can do it here and now.
Well, here's the pistol, and it looks like it's starting off good. Wabbit finds them the first kill, might even find them the second as he works on pushing his way forward, and the bomb's gone down here on the inner sight. So, again, the pistol going to go to Threes Up here on the T side of a CT-sided map. Will they make the same mistakes as they did on Cobble? Hopefully not, as Professor Chaos. Oh, there it is. Nice jump block.
Just that inner brute force push, and I mean, there wasn't much of a presence there for Luminosity playing pretty default, and they overrun kind of the anchor that we see Luminosity use on inner pretty much all the time, which is steel, and they just capitalize on that in a big, big way, and we are going to see Luminosity invest a little bit here. Oh, and that's a full-on force. Okay, they're getting upgraded pistols, they're getting the armor, they have a couple of flashbangs as well. Looks like they're actually going to be pushing inner a heck of a lot right now. Four people pressing the inner halls, and there's no one here.
Completely, both teams have gone to separate corners of the map.
But they could flank ladder pretty quick and still get out here and attack this. And if Cole can just stay alive, there's still some chance they could cause some ruckus.
Yeah, Wabbit. Oh, yeah, he's actually in CT Sky. That is a good point. Wabbit going up that ladder might fall because there's going to be a big distraction. Three people trying to work their way out of the ladder room. Steel, one of them with a deagle, finds a ridiculous shot onto Professor Chaos. He will go down to the nade. It's 2-on-2, and now Fur flanking from the mid room. Tap, tap, tapping with the CZ. Cold still up top here. With that deagle, he will take his time, peeks out again to find the headshot. They gotta find Jason R. I probably have a pretty good idea that he's down here in the Z connector. Actually, they have no idea. Both these guys are checking old bomb. So Fur goes down. Cold trying to get that AK. Cold with the 4K, so he was certainly the man in the pivotal position up there in CT Heaven or CT Sky. They lose the round, but it is still pretty expensive for Threes Up.
Yeah, I mean, they lose every single player. They have to rebound everyone, and Luminosity can't really punish that. They pretty much have to take a full save this round. So if Threes Up can win this round clean, then they'll start to get out of that tough position. But yeah, Cole just playing inside Heaven, never even left it, with the quad kill, made it dangerous. The only real problem is nobody had kits there for Luminosity, and they kind of ran out of time. And then, of course, they even got blindsided there at the end by Jason R. So good that Threes Up won, but like I said, took a lot of economic damage. But seems like they're making it through the outer bomb site pretty clear this time.
Was ambitious, going for the same spot two rounds in a row. This time, Threes Up are having none of it. Arya takes him out as the first kill of the round. Abe just waiting for the men to fall down the ladder, and they do. He finds a double. Arya boosted over, nicely done. Probably just did the jump himself, actually. And then there was Steel, all alone, and trying to find someone and take their AK into this next round.
Pretty much always looking to do is just try to see if he can do a little bit more damage, but gets caught there by Abe pretty quickly. And Threes Up only lose one player on this round, so that's good news. That means they don't have to do a lot of rebuying, so they can hope to build a little bit of a cash reserve. But Luminosity will be on their first full buy. We know how op intensive this map can be. There is none for Threes Up. Meanwhile, Fallen will have his out in the outer yard. So this will be a tougher challenge for sure for Threes Up, but we'll see if they're going to rise to the occasion here. So they're sending a lot of forces to Ivy, committing a lot over here, actually.
Yeah, the second round they've done that now. And here's Fallen. He gets that op up and immediately gets a first frag onto Arya. And we got Cold finding himself in a key position once again, waiting for this Ivy push, but he goes down immediately to Wabbit. Bolts will find one, spraying down a little bit more damage. And Fur now on the other side of the old bomb train just has him lined up. And there's Bolts assisting on both of those kills. So That's that. Bolt finds another one through the smoke. Abe trying to hide out by those boxes.
Yeah, I mean, it's just, you could see 3ZUP's goal was to get into back halls and try to use that to make some type of play, but when you have Fur being able to make a rotation as well as Steel rotating over from Enner, they pretty much just got trapped back there. They had no real access to the outer yard because Fallen's just, you know, watching the lanes with the op from the ladder room area, and they're just stuck back there. And the proper rotations came in for Luminosity to hold that off, and they take the opening gun round, 3ZUP buy up what they can, trying to storm outer, but Bolt's already with the first pick.
Yeah, they're making, big movements right away, Luminosity. By that, I mean Fallen. He plays that first round, op outside. Then he takes this op inner the very next round. Cold has been in CT Sky. The first rifle, he goes over and plays Ivy instead. So really mixing it up. Keeping 3ZUP guessing. I feel like 3ZUP haven't learned anything about what Luminosity is doing on the CT side because it's been different on both rifle rounds.
Yeah, definitely. This is a team that likes to move Fallen's op around a lot. Cobble was another example, right, where you see him predominantly maybe over the peak and take and picks double doors, but he'll definitely shift over to Statue at B, and this map is really no different. I mean, yeah, Steel's kind of the anchor and enter. That won't really change so much, but Fallen, certainly depending on the types of spawns that he can get, will certainly look to take picks at enter when given the opportunity, as now you see Steel and Fur playing double enter.
God, bolts. Chaos trying to be that one man outside that could have maybe gotten in there and been annoying had this intertake been slightly successful, but an M4 and an auto shotgun will not allow it.
And just the aggression for Luminosity inner, not able to deal with it over on the 3ZUP side. Now they are pretty much forced to take a save at this point. They could get a few Tech Nines here. I mean, Jason R does have a little bit of cash. Yeah, and they will go ahead and get a couple of smokes. Oh. One Zeus there on the Jason R, so see if he can make that work this time around.
My apologies for the health and ammo, guys. If you switch on and off camera, like auto director or cameraman, like the health and armor and ammo just disappears sometimes, so it comes back on if you toggle the map, so it's back. Steel kills Arya there through the smoke, once again throwing that smoke up the ramp and pushing in. And Fallen not going to allow Professor Chaos to jump. No jumping allowed in this outer yard. Or in the inner halls, just no. Say no to jumping.
Bolts also hit a pixel headshot on the guy creeping on a ladder inside the outer yard. So a lot of nice shots being hit there from Luminosity. You can definitely see they're kind of firing on all cylinders. I mean, I guess Fallen has been one who hasn't got a lot of frags yet this map, but other than that, frag distribution quite tight, and it was pretty much the same thing on Cobble. So they're definitely hitting their shots that they're taking. So 3ZUP are going to have to try to figure out a way to just still trade themselves through it as they, again, look like they want to test the waters a bit towards outer. But Fur, look at this aggression. No care in the world.
Oh, whoa! That kill onto Abe! Wow. I thought there was no way he gets more than one frag. I honestly didn't. I saw the flash go through. You didn't see the flashbang dance from any one of those terrorists. And he still was able to get one frag. That surprised me, let alone the second was just utterly ridiculous.
Yeah. Now Bolt's creeping up in a dangerous position, but Professor Chaos will actually pop flash through and catch that, so that was nice. They have it back into a 3-on-3, so there's definitely some hope here from 3ZUP.
Some fighting going on inside. That'll be Steel taking down Arya. Professor Chaos, though, slides into the Z connector completely unknown. How will they react to that? They know he's there now. I think it's Jason R they haven't quite spotted, but neither of these terrorists have that bomb. Pretty
important.
That's
way far off.
Yeah, and it's down on the inner ramp. Steel still covering that. And I might have this battle between Cold, who is at 90 HP, Professor Chaos at 100. He's actually going the other way. Now starting to get flanked here by Cold, who spots an easy frag. And it's Jason R all alone inside with an op.
Steel waits him out. So, yeah, this starting off well for 3ZUP, getting the pistol and not getting eco'd, but now they've lost the last five rounds in a row, and the money is just racking up on Luminosity side of things. Meanwhile, 3ZUP is starting to kind of approach that buy-save rotation now that they're at the max loss bonus and they're bought down so low. And again, they've only had like maybe one comfortable full buy this half already. So again, like their economy is just getting stretched to the limits, and they can't put together rounds. But they're gonna try another fast outer explosion here. Hopefully, Lavis Op can be more successful this time.
There it is. Takes Fur. Fur tries to go up on the train. Here is Fallen though, gonna shoot down Jason R. In hell. If he went to hell, he didn't have to go very far, did he? Wabbit will take down Bolts again from on top of the train. So Dust, you asking for Rabbit to have more of an impact? It is happening. But Fallen indeed, also with two kills. And they've spotted this boost. I think Fallen very lucky to be alive, and Cold going to be pushing through this.
What?
But,
nice. That was crazy.
That was nuts.
Yeah, that's something that, I mean, since Wabbit came to this team, I feel like he's an opera that, I mean, he used to play pro for teams like Savage and stuff a long time ago, took a big break, came back with SKDC earlier on in the year, had a tough start getting back into the game, but I feel like now that he's had some more time, he's really gotten back up to form, and his op's been really good towards the end of his time with SKDC, and with this team, it's been pretty on point. Last map, he was a bit quiet. That was a big round for him, though, to get three frags, help open up the outer site. They can get some more out of him like that, then they could still put together a pretty decent half. I mean, it's still in a situation where it's close. I mean, it's 5-4. There's still definitely room for Threes Up to work with to make this a close game and make a run at it.
And it looks like Fur will be giving up his position outside. Might deposit a smoke before he rotates, and now he will start rotating inside. Fallen still on the green train, and we can see Wabbit and Professor Chaos working their way inside. Steel, though, has got the first frag into Jason. Are he? What? Chaos continuing that spray. Fine Steel as well. That was pretty unreal. And it's a 4-on-3. Threes up, man advantage right now. Bolts to even it up. HP pretty much the same for both of these teams. Bolts a little low. He just took some nade damage there as well. And Chaos, what else can he do? He'll peek out into Fallen's op, and Fallen! Oh my gosh! Couldn't have missed that. The entire scope was filled with Abe. But Arya fighting, he finds too. It's Arya versus Fallen. Fallen using some ladder tricks and swinging around to the opposite side. Sees nothing. We'll try to pull out that incendiary bounce and get Arya to move. And, well, Arya moves, but he also shoots Fallen.
Yeah, I mean, that's really the two players, right? Professor Cash is getting a really sick spray down as he comes down the lower ramp to help open the site. And then Arya, at the very end there, comes up with what I believe was a 1v3 clutch. It might have been 1v2, but regardless, those two came up big for Threes Up to secure their fifth round. And now it's all tied up here. They're on the T side of this mat, so if they can just get one or two more rounds, they'll actually be sitting in really good shape, despite kind of the rough start when the gun round started happening. And it looks like they want to do some type of hit into outer again. Wabbit taking his op to Ivy, looking for someone to be peeking, but not finding it just yet.
Bolts. I mean, you see that smoke. What are you going to do? It's not like you can really miss if someone's walking down that corridor. And Jason Art has taken some damage from it. Abe as well. Both of them down into the 30s. And Jason Art falls to Bolts.
And Bolts did so much damage with that smoke. Abe is able to make the trade. Wabbit does have his op at Ivy, but he's not been able to get out and do much. And Fur and Steel and Cold all still in
Steel's
position.
Steel's in a rough spot now. Oh, but he still hits the shot onto Chaos. His Steel was getting overrun on both sides. He had Abe moving up on the right, Jason R on the left, but Steel just finds them both. And lives on 1 HP to tell the tale.
Wabbit's just starting to get out to the outer yard, but they actually shift gears over to inner, and they do get the take, so nicely done there from Arya and Abe to be able to find a way to get to the center bomb site. In the end, Steel will catch the op of Wabbit in the inner site, but now with 1 HP.
Yeah. He's been on 1 HP since that second kill. Gets that third one unscathed. Obviously, we'll have to do the same here, but it kind of works out. If Arya's going to keep using this op, I think they know it's Steel. He's fought three people at this point. They know he should be low. Arya does only have a Glock, though. I don't know if we'll trust that as his sidearm or just use a knife. Okay, he does pull out that op, so it's going to be one shot for Arya. And oh my god, Steel, don't fall off the train because you might die. He does it. He gets a 4K, somehow winning that round.
That's pretty insane. With 1 HP, able to come out with the clutch there, catching Labbit's op in the outer yard, and then winning that 1v1 there against Arya. Really well done, and that is Threes Up.
Did he
losing a round?
Did he hear that little footstep jumping up onto the ledge? Because it shouldn't make noise, but Steel, like, seemed like he really had the read on that situation.
I'm not sure. I didn't catch that part. But regardless, that's a big round to lose from Threes Up. I think they just never, like, putting Wabbit's op at Ivy like that and him not being able to get out and do anything, I think it really hurt him. It forced him to redirect enter. Yeah, they did get the take, but they're still unable to shut out the round. And now they're on to pretty much a force here, trying to take outer once again, but they're just getting absolutely shut down across the board.
Yeah, there were a lot of counter flashes there from Luminosity, and of course some smokes went down, which then some people pushed through for greeted them with bullets, which wasn't very nice. Arya and Jason are the ones left up now. Looks like the bomb, they were trying to fake the outer yard, fast take, and get a plant inner. And that's the thing about train, like, it is a very CT-sided map, but it does open itself up to for the terrorists to be able to get the bomb down pretty easily, which generally leads to a lot of rifle rounds, or at least, like, rifle on the force, like Tech 9 armors and then rifles. Gives them a decent chance on every round, but not finding it there. Luminosity with a really close round, and there they've got a pretty dominant, they've got their lead up to 2.
Yeah, and that was kind of a weird force buy last round because they really didn't have that much to work with, and now because of that, they're forced here to just go on the Tech Nines. And again, they weren't at a point in the half where they needed to do that. I mean, yeah, they were only down 6-5.
They must have really been hoping on the plant in that last round.
Yeah, I don't know. I think you might as well just took a save last round and have a full buy here. Again, you were only down 6-5. This is not a situation where you're pressured to force, and that happened once on Cobble, too, in the first half. So a little bit odd there on the money decisions that may come back to haunt them, but they're trying to take them to the inner site. They're getting out here. They might have a chance at a bomb plant at least, but now Steel and Bolt's chime in.
Oh, that... can we get some VAC in the chat? I'm sure it's already going.
Man. Seems like every time 3ZUP's about to catch a break, Luminosity just comes right back at him.
Luminosity just breaks their legs.
Still not a bad half, though, at this point. They still should get a full buy this next round. And... well, no. This is tough. They really shouldn't have made that buy on round 12. Look at this again now. I mean, that's three broken buys in a row when they could have had a save and a full buy when it was 6-5. That's kind of one of those unforgivable money mistakes.
Yeah, that's definitely what got them into nothing quite this ridiculous on Cobble, but they did get into a poor money situation on their Terra side of Cobble. Same thing kind of happening here late on Train. I mean, this is the 14th round. You're going to go into the last one now with much less than this. Unless maybe you convert this to a win. Wabbit does start it off with the Deagle headshot onto Bolt's Fur, taking down Arya, and we're in a 4-on-4 with all these Terras trying to swarm out into the outer yard, but Cold is here, stopping them in their tracks. 2-on-2.
We'll see. They still have a chance of this. They do have the op here onto Abe. They're getting outer yard. We do see Pressure Castle trying to creep that bomb through back halls to enter, which he could do. Steel might not be aware of this. Abe and Hell trying to come up here, falling this op and Ivy. Steel and Connector. Pressure Castle even get behind Steel and get a kill and then fall back to enter. That would be even more devastating. He goes for it, gets it, and now this is a free bomb plant enter. That's a big kill.
Made me a little nervous. That's the first shot, which doesn't usually end well for the people with Deagles. And it's up to fall on 1 versus 2. Oh, spots
he
that.
Caught that.
Yeah, I think he did. He knows a player is in there. He just goes for the Tech Nine.
But he has no clue where Abe is, right? There's no way he knows Abe is there as well.
He's going to tap the bomb, hoping that Abe did hear that. Both these guys have a kill on the round. Fallen, though, going for the 1v2. So we'll watch him tap the bomb once more and seize the arm of Abe. The incendiary goes out.
Is that enough to stop him from being able to... yeah, I think it was.
I think it might have been.
What a clutch Molotov.
Gosh.
What a clutch Molotov, man.
That was like a millisecond.
Yeah, that was kind of one of those, just one of those rounds where you just don't quite
know
how
it's
going to turn
those.
Out.
Nice one, Wabbit.
My. That's crazy. And the thing is, he didn't have a choice, right? If he would have stepped in the fire a little bit earlier, he would have died.
Would have died.
So there was really no choice but to play it like that. And it was an incredible effort to even win the 1v2. I mean, given the fact he had really no clue Abe was going to be flanking as well and able to hit that shot somehow, but just able to get the Molotov off before falling shot connected, and that's what won him the round. So despite that they've been in such a poor money situation for the past few rounds, they do fit the sixth round in, and they're trying to chance at this one as well, last round of the half.
Oh, Fallen does get taken down by that Tech Nine. Oh, Jason R. pulling out the Krieg, finds two kills with it. Best gun in the game, by the way. Finding a third. And it's Steel with the Nova. Who maybe will find this. He's definitely hearing those footsteps. Yeah, that's going to be Abe down. Jason R. is low. He already took a lot of damage.
Bomb's down.
Oh, my God. Yeah, I was like, oh, the bomb must be planted, right? Nope. Steel moving forward. Oh, okay. Shotgun.
Yeah, so...
shotgun, I mean, beats shotgun.
Yeah, I mean, despite the fact 3ZUP put themselves in a terrible situation money-wise thanks to kind of a ill-timed force buy, they still wound up getting the last two rounds of the half somehow, and so they still get a total of 7, which is perfectly respectable for this map.
Yeah, it turned out to be a pretty solid half. It was looking a little rough when, after the pistol, you got to the first rifle. Luminosity took 5 in a row. Pretty dominant, and then a little bit of a strike back, and then a couple really close rounds that could have gone either way. I mean, if that you see the defuse there in round 11 where just one person lived, I mean, if 3ZUP got that, they might have actually won the half, you know, 8-7 or 9-6.
Yeah, again, I think they could have had a much better half here if they wouldn't have, like, forced that on the 6-5 score. That was just, like, really ill-advised. But again, they get away with it because they still went out with the last two rounds of the half, so it's still, you know, perfectly reasonable. Then again, though, like that one round that, you know, Fawn doesn't get to defuse, that could have turned that into a 10-5 half play easily.
True.
So there was certainly a couple of tight situations there, but threes up came out on the better end there towards late in the half, and now they have a decent score to work with. They just got to try to win this pistol here. Luminosity looking to do a heavy Ivy hit themselves.
Uh-oh, Jason R. unable to stop that that Glock train with those USP bullets. That's about all that can do it. And instead, it just keeps on going through. Fur actually taking a detour, trying to maybe catch someone off in that lurk position at Old Bomb. Bolts, actually kind of a much-needed kill right there. Now engaging in a long-range battle with Abe.
Bomb stuck here,
looking
though.
On the wrong side of the spawn. It's on the other one where you've got Cold, who's still alive. Bolts taking his battle with Chaos right now, of which he will win. Professor Chaos caught jumping. And now Abe maybe in the same boat. Now down to 39. And Abe fighting two people at once, able to conceal himself from Cold, but Bolts taking that shot.
Him.
And yeah, Bolts with the 4K. He is, in terms of just raw frags, it seems like Bolts has kind of been the player tonight for Luminosity.
Yeah, and he's really set up his game in general for this team, right? Like, you know, when you look at Clues and some of the other events where you had moments where, like, Fur was a little bit off his game, it really was, you know, Bolts who kind of set up to fill that gap. And, I mean, I think he's another guy on this team that certainly can add to the firepower. And he's had a good game. And that was a key kill, not just for the four frags that he got, but just think about the situation there and where the bomb was at. It couldn't really cross into the site. It had too much defense against it, and Bolts still saves the day. And now Luminosity just... completely destroying that inner aggression from threes up, and they should put a 10th round on the board.
Steel kind of even got run boosted there. You saw how he landed on his teammate's head, and then like his teammate crouched, and Steel went flying off across the entrance there. It's pretty funny. I don't think it would have changed anything very much. Like maybe Steel would have died if he didn't have that extra speed, but still, Luminosity clean up. You know why they cleaned up? Because they had room brooms dust.
Oh, you enjoy it as now. Threes up, still forcing up a little bit here. You got Aria that has a Nova. So, listen down to $0 as well to get that. That's really odd
again.
Yeah,
that seems crazy. And
not
round 18 as well.
Yeah, again, this is not really a situation where you're that pressured to force by. I mean, you're on the CT side now. You're going to get guns next round.
God, Bolt. Things are just going Bolt's his way. Like, he's got a Galil at that distance, and he ends up finding that frag through the box. Like, get out of town, Bolt's.
And the gun, I guess, somewhat pays for itself now, because now, you know, it was $1,200 to buy that he got a kill, so
yeah.
He's only lost $300 at that point. So that makes it a bit better that he's able to get a frag. If he gets another one, then it more than pays for itself, but not going to be able to fall and catches him there. So Luminosity going to be up now, 11-7, but threes up. They'll have their first chance at a full buy. Abe going to be able to purchase an op, pass it off. Well, they'll do triple op setup. Okay, well, there you go.
Oh, right.
Except
oh,
for, like,
yo,
quadruple
okay,
op.
So...
they must not be taking this seriously.
Anymore. Not anymore, no. They're going no. Full Halo 5, shoddy snipes, more like snipes, shoddy.
Yeah.
But as you said at the start of this, I mean, it's a group stage match with Threes Up pretty much already out of the group. So there's not a whole lot of importance on it. So Threes Up gonna just opt in for
left.
The good time, right?
And this
I
could
have
been around with Luminosity not expecting
it. That's a very
it,
obvious
you know?
Pun.
There's a chance that this works the first time because they catch Luminosity so off
guard.
There's so many ops in play. But past that, not doing them any favors for their economy going forward if they do wind up losing this round.
Yeah, just about to say. The only thing that won't work out is if they lose, these things are expensive, and it will be another disastrous economic decision to throw Threes Up spiraling into debt.
Indeed.
Make their
as
home map Santorini.
And there is a point to be made. Luminosity, when this game does ensure the fact that they get the first seed out of this group, which will help them for seeding for the bracket for the qualifier. So they did have something to gain for winning tonight. So far this round, not going their way. The ops are working out a little bit here.
Yeah, there they are. Jason R actually gets one through the smoke, it looked like. I saw it from first perspective. Here's Cold with another frag, 2-on-2. And Bolt now has an op. I mean, there were so many to pick up. Why not? He gets a frag. Where is Chaos? He actually just unscopes as Cold decides to peek out. So now they know where Professor Chaos is. He will miss that shot. Cold on the ladder. Bolt's just up top taking shots. Chaos trying
and
to
I
work his way
And I can promise you that Professor Chaos would not be winning very many tickets right now at the arcade playing the whack-a-mole. He would have wasted that.
I was trying to figure out where you're going with that, but I like it.
I tried. If they're going to joke around, we might as well too, right? I mean...
Yes.
Of course, you've already fit in so many of
I've had a lot of jokes in already.
Yeah, I know.
See...
That's just you, though. That's just who you are.
I guess. I'm a clown. Arya. Nice. Dualies. I don't know if that'll really matter. I think the dualies are not good against armor whatsoever. Abe has got himself the first frag. Cold will take him down, and look at threes up. They've actually gone quite a ways out now onto this outer yard. Cold and Fallen hitting some more shots. Wabbit on the end of the green. Train with the P250. Might be able to get one. Does. Can he find any more? We'll find out. There's Cold waiting for him, so no. Wabbit can't find anything, and it's Arya, the man with two guns. The dueling dragons.
I got nothing.
Yeah, I don't
nothing,
either.
Nothing clever.
I mean, there's a pun built into it, just the name itself.
True.
So we don't even have to make one. It's been done for us.
Are you going to win us around
here?
Oh.
Are you going to do anything with these guns?
Might be able to catch this kill, but
he's hot on the
obviously didn't have much to work with after the quadruple op setup.
CSGO crashed randomly with no air
even
message.
Even CSGO's done with this game.
Yeah, right? See you next time.
And I will get back in here in a second. But yeah, I mean, obviously the quadruple op investment not paying off forces in this save allows them not to see an easy round, and they're on their way to a map point here shortly unless Threes Up can put up a final stand, so to speak. Really only going to get one more crack at it as far as money goes to really have a full comfortable buy to really put up a solid defense. So this is kind of their last chance in this map, I guess you could say.
And I'm almost back in.
And the quadruple op setup again with the Mac 7 is the choice here to try to get back into the game.
That's probably I mean, it is train, right? It's like almost maybe not the worst idea ever, but it's really just unfortunate they can't afford an auto. Imagine four autos, like that would probably work.
Well, I mean, this is the one map where I used to see triple op setups, like at least like back in Counter-Strike Source days when I casted that. Like that would sometimes be a thing. Double op, obviously, very viable on this map. But quadruple op, that's reaching out a little bit. The only time that quadruple op is viable is when you have a ton of cash last round T-side of Dust 2.
Yeah, exactly. Maybe last two if you really have a lot of cash.
Yeah.
And then, you know, if you're a really reputable team, you'll just get art put on the wall for it. I wasn't really a fan of that patch. But 14-7, they're broke. Threes up. We'll buy some shotguns. Or just two? Okay, Wabbit's still taking it seriously. Looks like Chaos and Arya have maybe checked out. And Jason R.
I can only imagine the waterfalls of salt that will
be taking
place.
You can almost make a sentence out of all the Threes Up players' names.
Okay.
I've got Jason, Arya, a rabbit. And I don't know how to work an O and Abe. Jason, Arya, a rabbit. I don't know. I guess the you get another. It doesn't really work. Take it back.
How about Jason? Like almost like a question mark after Jason. Jason, Arya, and Abe. Who win the wabbit?
And then you've got cold. You've got cold steel bolts. That kind of works. Cold steel bolts.
Cold
steel
fallen bolts for money.
I guess.
Hey,
I don't know.
That was pretty decent. But in the midst of all that,
I mean, Threes
Up
checked
out,
so obviously the casters did as well.
I mean, Threes Up just won that last round, though.
That's true.
A little bit of hope. The comeback is the dream is alive. So I guess we can check it back in now for a sec, see if this pans out.
Only for a second, though.
Yeah, quick outer explosion here from Luminosity, but being held off by Threes Up. Now, finally, another mid-air shot there from Wabbit, so they do put a quick stuff to this quick outer hit. Now they have 9 rounds.
A lot of people have died this game jumping behind electrical box and getting shot in the face immediately. It's kind of funny. It's also nice to see, right? Because like that used to be such a like a god spot to just jump and get information back when you couldn't be punished. Oh, it's nice to watch the punishment now. It's cathartic. As triple ops remain, as well as an MP9 there and Professor Chaos. Luminosity taking a quick inner, probably just going to get the bomb down, get some money. Arya's going to peek out for information, but will he get more than he bargains for? Does find a frag on the bolts, backs off. Nice Molotov to slow down the push. Fur taking 6 damage from that, wanting no more.
This inner hit, getting held off a bit. Luminosity's still going to go for it. The flank coming in, though, from Professor Chaos here, and he's already done some damage. It pulls them back. They're actually going to try to chase after him. They get the kill. Now the outer bomb site is actually open. Jason R will start to rotate. So is Abe. Labbit not too far behind. They should get here in time to really prevent it, but it forces them back. So now they're trying to double back to inner, but Arya waiting here with the op. Gets one already.
Yeah, nice shot. He did miss one after, and then missing another one there. That one will cost him his life and even it up. Also, Fur with an op. Maybe he can find Fallen and pass it over, or we'll just Fur.
He spotted this,
too. I'm sure Fur is capable as well, and waiting for the player to pop up on the coil. Not happening, though. Abe outside, looking for something. Nothing to find, actually. All of the members of Luminosity are up here in the box halls.
Now that they've been able to collect some kills and get some utility there, they're trying to think about what's their best option here. And they did spot Wabbit crossing. Fur was looking for the kill, but never found it. They passed the op back off to Fallen. And they still have the bomb on Fur here. They're running out of time, so they're going to have to make a decision here soon. It seems like Inner's still where they want to go. They're looking to see if Fallen can't find someone with this op, but Wabbit playing on the ground, so they won't be able to get him.
Oh, man. That was not the most comfortable of spray downs. Wabbit does find the one, but now not having armor doesn't really matter that much because it's just Abe with an op. So Fur and Fallen just going to do their thing, try to peek him. Well, end up peeking one by one. So it hasn't worked out. Nade way downtown. But Fur is uptown, and Fur has got the kill.
And that was just kind of a crazy round, but when they caught Arya's op in the upper halls and they're able to put it to use, they're getting into outer, and they do secure the round. So a close one, but it goes to Luminosity. Kind of a scrappy round. We definitely saw some weird spray down engagements take place on the ground, but it does wind up yielding Luminosity a map point here and a series point. You know, they're going to have 6 chances to close out this series in a 2-0 and secure that first seed for their group as they move on to the bracket play of this qualifier, as 2 North American teams will be joining 5 from EU and 1 from China for that $200,000 event.
China hype! Sorry. I'm pretty hyped for Asian teams to get back in the mix of Counter-Strike.
Indeed. And it'll be the first event of the year, pretty much. Very early January, and China will be involved in that event. That's pretty cool.
And the finals is in
Belarus.
Belarus this time, right? Not the Cyber Arena in Kiev. Well, they couldn't. I think they moved it because Chinese teams.
First event in Belarus actually for CS:GO that I'm aware of. Or at least a big LAN like this, $200,000.
I know the Chinese teams are having trouble traveling to Kiev in Dota. That's why they moved their Dota event around. So I guess it's probably the same situation for CS. But the reason they won another round there, so we're still in this one. Wabbit. Trying to find a kill through the smoke.
Been kind of back and forth these last 3 rounds. That's allowing Threes up a little bit of an opportunity here.
That was sick.
Impression from Wabbit and Abe from both sides of the map getting these kills.
They just had pistols, but that was still pretty sick from Wabbit. So it's cold. He's dead. 11 rounds for Threes up.
Yeah, so, I mean, a little bit legitimate chance here. They just need to get 4 more rounds, try to force this thing into overtime. Money is still low on Luminosity, so they will just be back onto forcing up pistols. Meanwhile, Threes up. Going to have pretty much a full spread across the board here, except for the Nova and the P90, but those still can be put to use, you know, playing under the ladder or pressing enter, which it seems like that's exactly where at least one of these guys are going. They're trying to get aggressive with them.
Uh-oh. Arya with the Zeus. Who was it in the last map? Was it Jason R that shot a Zeus and hit someone, but it didn't kill him? And I heard the Zeus go off. Looks like Arya had to pull out that AK to kill Fur. Here's Wabbit in those back halls on that inner bomb site. Finds one, and it gets cold on the flip side. Falling close with the P250. Gets one more, but still there were a lot of submachine guns, some shotguns in there for Threes up. So now going to be able to buy up in full. Luminosity just going to try to close it out. Fallen picks up the op, and AK utility coming in on everybody else.
Luminosity taking a couple of saves there to make sure they get full utility. Great job there by Abe and Wabbit. The double aggression on inner halls. Nice crossfire. Wabbit comes up with a hat trick in the end, so definitely a good hold. But now they have to go up against a fully equipped Luminosity, who have already shown us that they can get some T rounds here, and they're just one round away from ending the series. So this is 3's up. They're going to have to make a stand here if they want to keep the dream alive. They're trying to force this into an OT, and Nova from Professor Chaos getting on the ladder, getting a kill. Awkward spot, but it finds it. Gets the bomb down as well, but Steel collects the trade. Now they have a one-minute edge, and they're going to get the bomb back.
Steel living on 10 HP, and Cold still having worked. Ivy making his way back, finds Professor Chaos, who's pushing through. Actually,
that's
Abe
such a big frag.
Did some damage, and yeah, that was a big frag.
And if he gets through, Bolts, that could have changed everything.
They don't know that Bolt is out here. Oh, maybe they do. Jason R takes him out real quick. Also, Abe was working his way over to get on that as well. Steel hits the showers. He picks up that bomb. He's refreshed. He's ready to go to battle. Fallen working his way out with the op. Jason R to be smoked off. And what is that? A flash out? It is. Jason R going to push. Try to get on the bomb. Try to just move his position. They know he's an Ivy. And he finds a headshot onto Colt. It's Fallen.
Oh, no.
Who's just killed Steel.
Wow, that was insane. Like, well played by whoever that was with the op. I think it was Jason R.
Yeah,
like,
it was
realizing,
Jason
okay,
R.
This dude's planning. He's below me. He can't really challenge me. I'm just going to focus on his teammate. He gets that kill, and then Fallen tries to trade, but hits his teammate in the smoke by accident. And that accident causes pretty much an easy round there for 3's Up in the end to hold it off. And now we're going to see 3's Up again. They do have a chance to put this in OT, but again, they're just investing heavily in Ops. 3 Ops, not too far-fetched, but still a bit of a reach, probably. And that's kind of crazy to me. They're so close to getting this into a third map, and or at least in overtime, and they're still going to try to do something risky like this with a triple op.
I'm actually curious.
And they're, why that pushes ladder with the op. What the heck? You could put this in the OT. This is insane.
If I mean, I would assume they don't want to go to OT.
Maybe.
Based on they started buying 4 ops and somehow have still managed to get this pretty close now. I wonder, like, if we could go back in time and then 3's Up would do real buys, if they could actually have maybe won this
or
game. Or maybe the 4 ops, yeah, they actually, like, would have done better with these 4 ops. As, I don't know, it's been a bit strange. Fallen hitting Arya. And there's Fur with the last kill onto Wabbit. Sorry about the camera and sorry about whatever that was. 16-13 is the final score here on Train. And that means Luminosity took the series 2-0, winning both Cobble and then Train.
Yeah, I mean, again, questionable purchases for sure. One crazy 4 spot in the first half, which they got away with in the end because they still got 2 rounds and got 7 in the half. But we saw a couple of quad op purchases, despite the fact they were still within striking distance of making a comeback and, you know, maybe even ending it before, you know, it needed an overtime. And then even right there in the end, you know, they just needed a couple of rounds to force an OT. That was certainly reasonable to be able to do that. And they decided to triple op and push one of their ops up ladder on a weird play, and then they lose the game. So that was definitely just really silly, to be honest. I mean, at that point, there's not much to analyze, right? Like, it was just really silly play. It was very apparent. And with that, Luminosity take the game with ease. They do secure first out of their group for this qualifier, which will certainly help them seeding-wise when it goes into the playoff bracket. As, again, it is 2 North American teams who will come out of this qualifier to meet with the 5 Europeans and 1 Chinese team at that event in January in Belarus. 200 grand on the line. Going to be really cool, but I think we're done for the night, but we may have some more qualifiers going on for Star Ladder later on this, probably next week, actually, probably starting Sunday or something, so definitely keep your eyes out for it.
Yeah, and just real quick, you mentioned the NA teams going forward, so into the playoffs for just the after the bracket stage, into the playoffs still for online qualifiers, we've got Conquest playing Complexity Gaming. They both advance from their groups. And we've got what I think has come to be a pretty decent matchup, Games Academy playing pretty well at this recent RGN event. So it'll be most likely Luminosity Gaming versus Games Academy in the other upper bracket semifinal to start that off on the second stage of the online qualifier. So that should be pretty fun. And now that is all. Hopefully you've enjoyed tonight. I'm Helium. Get me on Twitter at HeliumBrella. Dust here at DustMurray. Let us know what you thought. As you'll probably see Dust a little bit more. Me occasionally here as you're watching the online qualifiers here for Star Ladder Season 14. See you next time.